Hey friends, welcome to this new video of Eduception. Here we are going to solve the second section of HCG paper 1 and let's get started.
Part 2, section A. You have to attempt any two questions from this section, but we are going to discuss all the three questions for you. Question 3. The powers and functions of the Indian Parliament are wide-ranging. In this context, answer the following. A. Explain three ways by which the legislature exercises control over the executive.
Now, there are many ways by which the Union Parliament can control the executive. Now, I'll name three for you. Number one is the question hour. Now, in question hour, people of the Union Parliament or members of the Union Parliament can ask questions about what's happening in the country to the government so that they can get the answers. Number two, adjournment motions. Now, motions can be adjourned under two circumstances. Number one, killing of an senior IPS officer in a place of worship. And number two, death of several persons due to consumption of unlicensed liquor. And number three, we have monetary controls. Now, when the budget is under consideration, there is a thing called cut motion. This is the way by which the Union Parliament controls the executive.
B. Mention any three special powers of the Rajya Sabha that is usually not enjoyed by the other house.
Now, three special powers. The first one is Rajya Sabha is a permanent chamber. It cannot be dissolved, but Lok Sabha can be dissolved. Number two, the Rajya Sabha can pass a resolution that the parliament can make laws with respect to the matters in state bills. And number three, Rajya Sabha may also declare a new creation for an All India service in national interest. So these are the special powers of Rajya Sabha.
See. Mention any two judicial powers and any two electoral powers of the Indian Parliament.
Now, two judicial powers of the Parliament first. Number one, the President can be removed from his or her office by impeachment. Now, there is a process after this, so you can read that in your book. And second, a judge of the Supreme Court or the High Court cannot be removed by the President except on a joint address by both the houses. Now, two electoral powers of the Indian Parliament. The Indian Parliament elects the President of India and elects the Vice President of India. So this is your answer.
Question 4. The Union Executive, which consists of the President, Prime Minister and the Council of Ministers, is a powerful body in a parliamentary democracy. In this context, answer the following questions. A. State the position of the Prime Minister and state any two of his powers in relation to the President.
Now, Prime Minister is the head of the Council of Ministers.
Yeah.
He is also the leader of the party or coalition which commands a majority in the Lok Sabha. This is the position of Prime Minister. He is the executive head in a sense. And two of his powers in relation to the President. Number one, Prime Minister is the link between the President and his Council of Ministers. The Prime Minister conveys everything to the President. And number two, it is on the advice of the Prime Minister that the President summons or blocks the parliament or dissolves the Lok Sabha.
Okay. B. You have to mention the three categories of ministers in order of their rank and status.
Now, three categories of ministers are number one, cabinet ministers.
Yeah.
Number two, ministers of state.
Mm-hmm.
And number three, deputy ministers.
Yeah.
Now, you can read that in your book and elaborate.
Okay. C. Mention any four legislative powers of the cabinet.
The legislative functions of the cabinet are as following. Number one, although the houses are summoned by the president, initiative in this matter is taken by the Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs. Number two, the cabinet prepares the president's special address to the parliament. Number three, in the matter of issuing ordinances, as in other matters, the president acts on the advice of the ministers. And number four, the cabinet is the instrumental body in planning and moving an amendment to the constitution.
Question 5. With reference to the powers and functions of the High Court, we have to explain briefly the meaning and scope of the following. A. Its appellate jurisdiction.
Now, appellate jurisdiction means the cases which can be appealed in High Court. Now, this can be of two types, criminal cases and civil cases. Now, civil cases, any appeals against the decision of the district judges, it can be heard in the High Court. And in criminal cases, against the judgment of a sessions judge, an additional sessions judge, a magistrate and many other judges can be heard in the High Court. Now, there is a lot of things in this. You can elaborate it by studying from a book.
Okay. B. The High Court as a court of record.
Now, court of record simply means that a court keeps the record of the previous cases, which can be used as precedent during other cases. It also means that if a person commits a contempt of high court, the court has the authority to punish them. Neither the Supreme Court nor the Parliament can dissolve this power.
Okay. C. Judicial review.
Now, judicial review simply means that the High Court is guardian and the interpreter of the Constitution of India.
Absolutely.
Now, if it finds anything is going beyond the provision of law, it can make that act null and void.
Okay.
Now, here we come to an end of this video. If you like the video, please hit the thumbs up and the subscribe button. And don't forget to share it with your friends. Next video coming soon. Stay tuned.